Philosophy does not solve problems. The duty of philosophy is not to solve problems, but to redefine problems, to show how what we experience as a problem is a false problem. If what we experience as a problem is a true problem, then you don't need philosophy. For example, let's say that now there would be a deadly virus coming from outer space, so not in any way mediated through our human history, and it would threaten all of us. We don't need basically philosophy there. We simply need good science desperately to find, we would desperately need good science to find the solution to stop this virus. We don't need philosophy there because the threat is a real threat directly. You cannot play philosophical tricks and say, no, this is not the th-. You know what I mean? It's simply our life would be in, or, okay, the more vulgar, even simpler science fiction scenario. It's kind of Armageddon or whatever, no deep impact, a big comet threatening to hit Earth. You don't need philosophy here. You need, I don't know, to be a little bit naive, I don't know, strong atomic bombs to explode, maybe. Maybe, I think it's maybe too utopian, but you know what I mean. I mean, the threat is there, you see it. In such a situation, you don't need philosophy.
I don't think that philosophers ever provided answers, but I think this was the greatness of philosophy. No, not in this common sense that the philosophers just ask us questions and so on. I mean, what is philosophy? Philosophy is not what some people think, some crazy exercise in absolute truth, and then you can adopt, you know, this skeptical attitude. We, true scientists, are dealing with actual, measurable, solvable problems. Philosophers just ask stupid metaphysical questions and so on, play with absolute truth, which we all know is inaccessible. No, I think philosophy is a very modest discipline. Philosophy asks a different question, the true philosophy. How does a philosopher approach the problem of freedom? It's not, are we free or not? Is there God or not? It asks a simple question, which would be called a hermeneutic question. What does it mean to be free? So this is what philosophy basically does. It just asks, when we use certain notions, when we do certain acts and so on, what is the implicit horizon of understanding? It doesn't ask these stupid ideal questions, is there truth? No. The question is, what do you mean when you say this is true? So you can see, it's a very modest thing, philosophy. Philosophers are not the madmen who search for some eternal truth and so on and so on.